This narrow and lonely road leads to a mixed secondary school, Isele Azagba, in a Neucha North local government area of Delta State. Gunmen invaded the school, shooting sporadically and attempted to adopt the school principal and some teachers. The quick intervention of the community vigilante group and security agencies, however, foiled the kidnap, but two people were killed.
Already they succeeded in carrying about four of them, including principal. So we start pursuing them. They gave them order from police. Every police, more than 15, 10, all of us enter bush, combing, following them. They were shooting, we were pursuing them. Until they release the first person, the principal, who followed them. Battle to battle, until we get they leave the other ones and run.
We are afraid. The teachers are even joining us to pushing us. Some people are pushing us. When we got to the next village, they now asked us to stop. Even the village people, the next village, they are all of us, all of the school, they are following us to be running away.
Members of the community say they now live in fear, not knowing what could happen next.
We are in fear. Even yesterday, most of the people left Iselazaba to the nearest village. Some went to Asaba. Some slept in people's house.
Confirming the deaths, the state's police command says investigations are ongoing.
Apart from the teacher, much later they said those who went for the rescue mission, that one of the youth was missing. And so they had to go into the forest, and the following day they saw his corpse. But we are still investigating to find out what actually happened, because they went in groups. So how come nobody knew when something happened to him?
Our collaboration with vigilante group is a step in the right direction. We hope to continue to strengthen them, because what has happened has shown that using the vigilante groups in collaboration with other security outfits have continued to put sway in different sectors.
For now, the school has remained closed as all the students and teachers are yet to recover from their trauma. The rescue victims are currently being treated at the Federal Medical Center in Asaba, the state capital.